Hello friends, welcome back to another video tutorial from Shomu's Biology. And in this particular lecture, I'm going to talk about Unit 10. Okay, so I've been giving you all the different tips and tricks to prepare different units of CSIRnet exam. So we have talked about the other units. This is about Unit 10, how you should prepare Unit 10 in a better way. What are the tips? Okay, so here is what you need to do about Unit 10. Unit 10 is ecology and environmental biology. So you can divide them into two different parts, ecology part and the environmental biology pollution part. So the total number of questions asked in Unit 10 is kind of fixed in June NET as well as in December NET. And this is a really scoring unit, and this is a very important unit. So you should always attain Unit 10. So as I was telling that you must prepare Unit 10. This is the first thing that you should do. You must prepare Unit 10. That should be your first pick. Now the second thing is that we can divide this Unit 10 into different subtopics. One of this topic is population ecology. The second topic is community ecology. The third topic is ecosystem ecology. And the fourth topic is biodiversity and conservation. And the fifth topic is pollution and related issues. So these are the five topics, and you can expect near about 6-7 questions in part C, 5-7 questions in part C from Unit 10, and also 6-7 questions in part B from Unit 10 itself. So that's why Unit 10 is very, very important. And why I told you that you should always prepare Unit 10? The reason behind it is that the questions asked from Unit 10, from environmental biology, ecology, is kind of easy to answer. It's not that difficult. Okay, so there is no mechanism-based question. Just like, you know, in biochemistry, cell biology, in molecular biology, there are always mechanism-based questions where you need to put a lot of information in to connect the concepts in order to answer that. While in Unit 10, the questions are sometimes direct. For example, from population ecology, they can ask you a question related to R and K selected species, or they can ask you a question regarding different types of type 1, type 10, type 3 survivorship curve, or they can ask you regarding the sigmoidal curve of growth, logistic growth, and all these different types of growth, population growth. They can ask you a question regarding character displacement, question regarding the niche concept, okay, so how the organisms are living together. In ecosystem ecology, they can ask you a question regarding our biome. They can ask you a question regarding different types of ecosystem, terrestrial ecosystem, as well as the ocean ecosystem, the different zones of ocean, soil zone, and all these things. So these are important. So in Unit 10, you will find out things which you need to have a good grasp concept. The concept based part is kind of 30 or 40%, and rest 60-70% is memory based, because you need to remember many things about this unit. Because they will also ask you question regarding like different types of ecosystem law, okay, like Dolo's law, Cope's law, or for example the Bergman's rule, Allen's rule, all these things. So those things you need to remember in your head. Similarly, there are questions regarding Indian subcontinent, okay, and the different places in India, biosphere reserves in India, the type of biosphere reserve, the name of the biosphere reserve, what kind of what that biosphere reserve is famous for. So all these things you need to put in your mind. These are memory type. So you will get both the memory type questions as well as the concept based questions in Unit 10. The concept based questions will be from population genetics. Some math problems may also come from population genetics, Lotka-Volterra model, those things. Okay. And also the Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium, which is population genetics, another very, very important part of this Unit 10, or you can also hold it as a part of Unit 11. So it's kind of bridge between Unit 11 and 10. So this kind of question you can expect. So the best thing for Unit 10 preparation is that have a first of all, an overall knowledge about the environment, about the ecosystem. And the best book to prepare for it is that you don't need to read the complete detailed ecosystem ecology books. Campbell Biology has a very good 3-4 chapters for this Unit 10. The reason I choose Campbell Biology, because, you know, although it's for the school level in US, in other countries, but I choose this to get your basic concepts clear, because in Campbell Biology the illustrations and the analogies are so good, so well put, the pictures are so good, the figure legends are so good, so that you can read it and you can put it in your brain quite easily. Then you can take it up a notch by reading it from any other book, the book list that we already shared, already discussed in other video. So you can read it from the other books as well, okay, ecology, like Odum, Smith, all these things are there. But particularly these topics are very, very important for this whole Unit 10, okay. So you divide these two portions. The conceptual portion you need to study at the beginning of your preparation. And the topic to be memorized or memory-based concepts, those memory-based topics you need to prepare just before 1 month or 1.5 month before the exam. So while you are reading this unit 10, you should properly distinguish between the topics which are conceptual and which are memory based. So prepare conceptual at the beginning of your preparation and then prepare the memory based just the last few months of the last 1 or 2 months of the preparation. And you can clearly see that the type of question in unit 10, you will see most of these questions are related to the concepts as well as sometimes they are related to graph analysis. Okay, so you need to have a good idea, good sense of graph analysis. And this is very, very important because there will be graph in population ecology, there will be graph in those RK selected species and all these things. And there are different relationship will be provided in the graph. So you need to be able to understand the graph analysis. Okay, so I'll be making another video regarding how to analyze graph properly. But for now, you need to have a clear understanding of graph. Now, the most important thing about the graph is that when you look into a graph, we always make a mistake. The mistake that we make is that we try to remember the looks of the graph. You know, how the graph looks like. Is it S-shaped or like just a parabolic shape, or it is something like J-shaped or things like that. Okay, so we always think the way graph looks, and that is the biggest mistake that we do. While you're reading a graph or understanding a graph, what you need to understand is what is present in the x-axis, what is present in the y-axis. That is the most important thing, because x is something on which y depends. Okay, so for example, in a population growth curve, in the x-axis there will be time, in the y-axis there will be number of individuals in the population. Because as the time passes, the population may increase in size or may decrease in size. Okay, so the dependable thing is on the y-axis, and the thing on which you are depending in the x-axis. So always remember what is x and what is y for a graph. You don't need to remember what it looks like. You need to know what is in the x, what is in the y, and the relationship between x and y. That's how you can solve any graph. You can recall any graph and can draw that graph on your own. Another very crucial thing while you're looking into a graph and putting in your brain is that don't try to mug up. As I said, just understand the x and y and correlation between them. And the second thing is that of where the graph is starting from. Is it starting from the zero or point, or is it starting some point up? For example, you're talking about a population growth. You can never draw a graph from zero. Right, because if the number of individual at the beginning was zero, how can the population grow? So at least it will be two or one individual. From there it start growing. So this is a kind of idea that you need to put in your mind while thinking of analyzing and answering graph related question, which is very unique and mostly asked in unit 10. So if you follow this 20 tips, I think your unit 10 is going to be pretty good. And if you follow last few years question paper, you will see the question is asked from a few topics repeatedly. Only prepare those topics and do not lift unit 10, because believe me, from those 6-7 questions, if you prepare moderately, then you will be able to answer 4-5 questions. If you prepare good, you'll be able to answer all the questions from unit 10. And 6-7 questions answered from unit 10 in part C is a good advantage. So this is a unit you need to practice. So that's all about the tips how to prepare unit 10 for CSIRnet exam. If you like this video, please hit the like button, share this video with your friends, and subscribe this channel. Click the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a new video. Thank you very much. Bye.